But I've still done it. Okay, I'm still going. So are you joining for halfway or you're going now?
I think let me just join halfway.
Okay. All right, on 99.5 for Zobia FM, now we don't talk. So this now radio took mouth and as it be like this, we don't enter the time for a tipsy voice on radio. That I want to go and get program where we say a tipsy, they carry come your tomorrow every Saturday by 7 o'clock. If you don't know what the a tipsy be, it means action against trafficking in persons and smuggling of migrants. That no longer project will be say European Union, they carry come together with FIAP. FIAP now one Spanish government joint body. Obviously, they collaborate to fit bring you this program. My name is Ugun Nachinatu, landlord of Azubia FM. And another alone for inside studio.
Yes, so my name is Uncle Joe, and maybe the person where they come, where they connect communication for ATFSIN. And tonight, we will discuss about supporting the victims of human trafficking and smuggled migrants. And we get person with the expert. This person don't they train so many survivors for trafficking. His name na this name
I Hawu
Victor. So he's the founder of Center for Youth Integrated Development with the for Lagos and Abuja. So he go join us live.
Okay, so right now, if you want to join us live too for inside studio, enter Facebook, just type ATPC Nigeria, and you go see us live and direct. Okay, we'll try to call them to know. Yes. Okay, hello, good evening, Oga Victor.
Yeah, good evening.
Yes, so my name is Uguna Chinatu and Uncle Joe, they inside studio. Welcome to 99.5 for Azubia FM.
My pleasure.
All right, so. If you just join us right now, we just speak to Oga Victor Ihawu. We get him.
You try.
Okay. Oga Victor. Okay, now he be the founder of Center for Youth Integrated Development. But before we enter the main go for the topic we say 1-3 today, Oga Victor, help us explain. Waiting they make person be victim of human trafficking, or waiting they even make where we say then they smuggle people. Help us explain on top of that level.
Which language do you speak first? Make our best understand.
Okay. The question now, or people speak for English, maybe you don't understand Pidgin. What makes one a victim of human trafficking?
No, I understand the question very well. I just want to know which one would they use. I mean, I've been
okay, hey, now Pidgin. Now Pidgin.
But if you're not confident for Pidgin, okay.
I will try.
Okay, no wala.
Okay, people where they call victim of trafficking, now people where they receive with the promise say they will give them better work for us.
Okay.
And then people will be migrants when they smuggle. People now people will be say they know where did they go? They just won't go somewhere. Maybe they don't even meet up the requirements where we'll carry them go the place through direct means. So they go pay somebody, make the person carry them go the country where they won't go. So because once they don't carry you through the regular means, it is a you don't get smuggled. If you want smuggled, we all know what anything that is smuggled. It's contraband, it's against the law. But then, basically, when they smuggle, if it also end up becoming the first group of people which are the victims of trafficking in person. Because along the line, if you reach one place where you say the money where you get, if you don't reach where you won't go. And then if you come big person for there, we go pick them and say, I can help you reach where you want to go. Without real concrete agreement, what you need to pay back. So if this starts the journey as a smuggled migrant and end up being the
So you talk say longer throats, they contribute for people, they fall trap of these human traffickers.
It don't really be longer throats. If house good, nobody won't come out.
So
when house no good, people they come out. And when they come out, for instance, if you want pass through desert officially, you are supposed to have 5 liters of thereabout of drinkable water. Back then. Now these people don't want to pass that desert. They don't even know about all those things. They just won't go. And when they reach the desert, then they will not say, oh, life not very easy. At that point in time, they don't become vulnerable. So any opportunity, so to say, when they see, they will grab them. Irrespective of how we can end up for them.
Okay, as you don't explain that one, it makes sense. So what be the challenges where we say these people where they traffic or where they smuggle they face? What that they suffer for the process of this smuggling?
Well, the people where they traffic, then they suffer plenty, you know. Of course, generally we don't say that they take home, and when somebody don't take home, you know, the big talk what you mean.
Finish up. Thank you, Oga Victor. So, because the topic we dey treat today now, how will we support these people we say they don't traffic, or the ones who we say they don't smuggle, where they manage even carry come back, the ones who they manage or support or help back to nothing, they don't get anything. Some of them for people they don't traffic, or the ones will be say they smuggle. How the fit take empower these people?
Well, all of them, and once they come back to the country, they'll be the same people. They don't worry, they don't come back. Now, interestingly, government did not get any special program where they won't do for them. But as far as me, I think content say, once you don't go, you don't get back, you don't come back. along the programs where you meet program where people will never go before, they could use a good 2 days. Any intervention program where they are going to find, just find your way. Now, in terms of developing programs, it would come like that. The same thing where they're supposed to for them, actually, they're supposed to take them through some psychosocial programs, trauma healing programs. You know, the two of them, they are the same thing, but, you know, when people hear of trauma, when people hear of mental health issues, they may always put an amendment, but not upon them. As far as Nigeria says, now all of us know where.
Anyway.
Do you understand? You know, so we actually need some kind of mental health support. Not to talk of people when they say, you know, they don't go through, some of them don't see how people die, some of them don't see, they don't see finish. Life don't mean anything to them again. And then if they bring them home back to the country where they don't get to lose hope on. So the first thing where they're supposed to give those people is a serious psychosocial support, as in trauma healing. They're supposed to take them through some kind of trauma healing. So the point is to say, then go, don't get ready, say, ahead, I don't come back, I won't pay for this country now. Before they will go start all this environment training program and all the rest. Because, you know, trauma, the major aim, the objective of trauma is actually to change the priority of the mind. And once the priority of the mind don't change, that's a defeat process. Anything going down to where the mind suggests, so right, you just go up. If it's not finished, you'll come regret, or you go down, you go down, go up. So the first step to help the people is just to take them through psychosocial support, serious trauma healing. We are not supposed to be in a rush, you know, to implement whatever program we want to for them. We need to take them, you know, and people will go up. The people will say they get passion for this work. Not be telling people they go up because they won't give them money. There are two different things. People will get passion for them. Whether you pay them or you don't pay them, and work with the organization to do. People when they pay to do them, they get timeline. So whether you achieve results or you don't achieve results, and when they don't do it, then they don't do that. But you get some organization where you say, once they come, as long as they want to remain with them, working with them, is when their mind don't settle, you know, I don't try.
Okay, but apart from this psychological part where you say they need, you know, make them go, make them do that some kind of psychological treatment, which other kind of empowerment? I mean, because I feel say then just they enter the country, they don't get any money. Most of them will be say just they come back, that's the small good ones or the ones with the traffic, they don't even get anybody, they don't even get transport to locate their village. So you don't get any like financial empowerment or based on work level. Because most of them, I feel said they don't even lost their certificates. How will it help to put them back for inside society, as they call it, rehabilitate them back, make them enter inside society? Apart from this psychological way, now explain, I understand that one. But you get any like financial or where, as it take consign work, whether they will give them work or they'll give them money or give them business, make them do to fit enter back to the society. Because if they come back, nothing. That means they were going to put out for some kind of bad things. Now, what do you mean? So, what is exactly where these people they need apart from the psychological part where you don't explain?
Yes, apart from the psychological aspect, different organizations get different economic empowerment programs. Whether they do for them, why is that psychological is important? You don't build on wrong foundation. Because any moment where you keep that away, my concept, the way you do the wrong work pleasure. If you get pleasure with this money, your mind will take so. By the time you pleasure finish, your mind will go back to the way it is. So there is a lot of economic empowerment programs. You get an organization what you say, and they need people for airport, give them transport to go back to their places, those where they own their own goal. And those where they get where they own goal. You also get an organization to work at shelter. You know, when they offer this shelter to people before they go even come back any of those programs. So in terms of economic empowerment programs, there are a lot of them where they be taken through. But even my organization, we did one recently for some of them, this CDM aspects program. we don't work with some people. Then the country went to send them come back. Before they come, they agreed on certain amount of money based on the wages they tell those people that they need to. So they agree on that a certain amount of money where they will give them, come back, but they will not give them the money for hand. You know, they will give all the money. Then when they come here, we will come around, they buy all the things. Like, that's not a business for them to run. You know, but that right now, we don't have to do anything called psychosocial or whatever. So we just come and say, after you don't set up the business for them, 2-3 weeks later, by the time you call them, before, no, they will.
They will.
Let them hurry up, so that. Movement, that's when we actually change the pattern of our integration. I think before you even begin, that you won't give someone economic empowerment. I think it's very bad in mind, don't even pay a little bit less. So, like I said, at the moment, plenty of programs there is where it's a different organization to do to help these people to resettle. But then you need to also understand that this set of people, they are one of the most difficult people to work with. Because, like I said before, the priority of their people don't change. They don't be trust. They don't even trust anybody. So if somebody give you $1 to give them, they don't show them that $1 they give you to give them. You know, they don't give you 20 money. You just going to give them $1, and they don't will just trust you for nothing.
Okay.
So it requires a lot of patience to work with this group of people. Like I said, a lot of organizations are doing wonderful job. Not because they won't take them make money, you know, but just to see, say, oh, this one are their own ministry, they don't want to start church. They don't want to start mosque. This one are their own mosque, you know, when you go to reach humanity.
Okay.
They also have bills to pay, so they need people to help them so that they don't get tired along the way.
All right. Okay, Victor, now you be the founder of Center for Youth Integrated Development. You'll be CYID. The question I want to ask you now, what is this your joint body they do to fit empower, to fit support, or to help people will be say they don't traffic or smuggle? I said, okay. Now you be the founder of Center for Youth Integrated Development. No be so. So what did this organization they do to fit empower or to help or to support these trafficked people? We don't come back. So when they come back, now they carry them. Victor, you will just give us like 2 or 3 minutes. Maybe we open phone line because I know say it gets some people they listen to you. 0705-995-0995. The number is 0700-995-0995. Then we did live on inside Facebook. Just type Atipsom Nigeria. That's na A-T-I-P-S-O-M. A-T-I-P-S-O-M. And then you will see us live for inside Facebook in case you want to drop any comment for inside that area. Help us increase the volume of your voice. Hello? My brother Jerry, what be your name and where they call us from?
Bulala, the street.
Bulala, well done. What be the question we say you want to ask about Victor this evening?
No, I want to give her more encouragement. Because
amen.
Make him carry the work because now by the God grace in the Sicilian work. And the way I want to advise those people where they did that last week. Where they to get my number by force so when they don't prefer they will not go see money. We could cut our coat according to our size because all this can be, if you show a good way, you must, your body must get rest. And then we could identify the many cut their coat according to their size as well.
All right, so thank you very much, Bulala. Hello? Hello?
Hello.
Good evening. What is your name and where they call us from?
My name is Daniel, calling from Suleja.
Daniel from Suleja, will they hear you?
Yes. First time caller,
collect them.
Thank you. My question to the Honorable Material is, all these are our brothers who are coming from abroad, and not many of them died on the way. Is there any assistance to their family?
Oh, very good question. All right, thank you. Okay, Victor, you hear the question?
I don't hear that word.
He say all these people, we say they when they won't come back, maybe something can happen, they can't die for road. You get any help? We say that they help the family.
No.
No help at all.
Yeah.
What of the
most of them when they die for that they bury them for them?
Did they bury them there?
Yeah, they bury them plenty.
Kai. Okay. We'll just pick one call. Shapali. Hello? Hello?
Hello?
Good evening. What is your name? Where they call us from?
I'm calling from Moraba.
Okay. You get 30 seconds. Ask your question. Hello? This guy anyway, just walk off. All right, okay, Victor, the way the matter take be our time, you know, they do pull up. Just use like 2 minutes, take round up or round off everything where we say you guys talk on top of this matter. And if you get any advice, because you get one talk where you been talk when we start, you say you get more things where our government than guys do to fit help these people. Just under these 2 minutes, what do you guys talk on top the level, your own advice to government and to other different joint body then we'll be sitting to listen to you right now.
Well, I think I prefer to just give general advice to all our people.
Okay.
And my advice is the fact that the homeland is greener. No matter how bad it appears, the homeland is greener.
So that's not the advice.
Yeah, that's the advice.
Recommend or give advice to governments on top how they fit help to support these trafficked people. What do you go advise them?
new interest to help humanity. So whether you will pay them or you don't pay them, now what would they like to do? To make them partner more with them, make them give them ownership of this humanitarian work. Then the consistency will go enter the next level, because most of the rating what they do recently, you know, just pay for within far at all. It's like they don't work at all then.
Hi. All right. All right, so thank you very much, Oga Victor. And thank you. Okay, so Oga Victor Naim be the founder of Center for Youth Integrated Development. Now he will be say we just talk to finish. Well, we go close mouth on top the level of a tipsing voice on radio, but not touch your radio because we see the inside studio and more informate 90 on top a tipsing. Now you will be saying they listen to us. You feel follow a tipsing for inside your social media page will be a tipsing Nigeria. If you enter Facebook, just type a tipsing Nigeria, you go see their page. Follow the page, like their different comments, like their different posts, and anything. Even from there, you feel they get more information about what in them they do on top the level of their work to fight human trafficking. Then if you enter inside Instagram, you go see them too for ATPSIM Nigeria. Then Twitter, if you enter there, you go see them. And as they always do, every month they do giveaway. Every month they do giveaway based on, say, at the end of the month, the last Saturday, then they ask question. The question are based on what we don't discuss from the first Saturday, second Saturday, third Saturday. After every, the person will get them go win prize. And since when we say they start them, plenty of bunga prizes, man. Different people don't they win based on their ATIP scene. Out on top the level as the tech be a tipsim, make we join hands to end human trafficking and smuggling of migrants, because you see this fight against human trafficking, whether you like them or not, now fight will be say everybody supposed to join hand to do them. Sometimes you yourself, you don't even know say you don't help human trafficking based on say you don't know who be has. Some people, the house girl and the husband, where they get, they don't know the papa, they don't know the mama, my person carry cup. Come carry another one, give. Go up before you can reach your hand. That one, another form of human trafficking. So you guys know some kind of information we concern this thing to make sure, say, you unknowingly need the support or do you. Of migrants.
And SMBs is the foremost lucrative illicit business in the world. The project aims to combat trafficking in persons and smuggling of migrants at national and regional levels to the European Union by providing support to